To illustrate the need for malware analysis and the challenges associated with it, let's consider one of the common malware obfuscation techniques, packing. Packing refers to the process of compressing and encrypting part of an executable program. The result of packing is that part of the executable program now becomes data instead of instruction set. And in order to execute that part of the program that has been packed in runtime, we must reverse it back from data to instruction set. That is, we now must include in the executable program some code that will reverse this packing process, and this is called the unpacking. To give an illustrative example, we have the original program, program A here, and you see that the program contains instruction sets. With a packing tool that include compression and encryption and so on, the result of packing is that part of the program, meaning part of the instruction set, now becomes data. We observe that the packing result looks random, meaning the data here looks random. This is because it is encrypted with a randomly generated key each time the packing program is run on a malware program. That is, even for the same malware program, each packed instance will look different. And therefore, a signature-based approach is not effective in detecting the packed malware. Now you say, this packed program will include code that try to unpack the packed part. Can we use the unpacking code as signature to detect malware? The answer is no. The reason is that legitimate programs may also include packing in order to hide certain logic and data, for example, for copyright protection. That is, some legitimate programs also have unpacking code that will unpack some part of the program in runtime. Therefore, we cannot use the unpacking code as signature to detect malware.